Hello.
Hello, what are you doing?
It's my brother Andrew.
Nice to see you.
But me and my brother both visited this brewery a few times. It's one of the breweries that I started getting into, the Black Marie, or Black Marie, whichever you want to pronounce it, from the Old Bear. Andrew's had this a few times. When did you, first time you said you had it?
Well, I can't remember the first time I had it, but I think the second time I had it was at a beer festival, and it was the Keighley one on the tap, and it was 40. I think it was 14.5% then, but this one's 12.5%, and we did pick a bottle of after the festival. And it was a dead beer, but Stuart's picked up as well. And,
now this beer, best before December 2010. Right, a beer like this normally has 2 years before that. So this was bottled before I started drinking really ale.
Let's just find out.
And also, this is a very rare beer for a simple reason, is it doesn't get made anymore.
Yeah.
They stopped producing it. But anyway,
it was a good beer when I tried it at the festival,
though. Now, what I need to answer is, did this beer explode when you opened it?
No. I think it was pretty much dead.
Okay. So, we'll open it away from my laptop just in case.
See how I did it, bro.
Yeah. It's 12.5%.
I'm surprised it's held a cup of water.
Now, I've not had that much luck with Old Bear on bottle, and as of late, not on tap either. Very watery.
A lot of their beers are usually watery, though, aren't they? Look at that one. It's just half clear. Is that just like...
Looks like pure caramel water, isn't it?
Yeah, I don't know.
It's like a... It's almost like rock iced tea.
Yeah. You got milk.
So,
right.
A beer that's... It's 2013 now, so it's... A beer that's probably about 5 years old.
Bit worth it. That brain freeze. Very poignant on the smell, it's like almost not sure. But here we go.
It smells like mould and bricks and such. Polish.
Tastes like locust here this month.
I don't want to drink it. Last time I had an Old Bear on bottle.
Either locust or Tizer or something.
Anyway. Mum and Dad, I love you. That's disgusting. I'm not drinking that.
You wanted it.
Oh man.
Anyway. Anyway, what do you think about that? Right, you over.
No, it's horrible. Taste in mouth.
Have another drink.
Oh, do you know what it reminds me of? Do you remember that dodgy cider?
Yeah.
It's like that. It's like apple-y, It's like a sour. This is almost like a sour.
Is it sour beer now?
It probably won't.
It's changed into a sour beer.
Now, normally a 12.5% beer would last for a long time, wouldn't it?
Well, you said it would last, but...
That being said, we have to give a beer. It might taste bad first. You got to keep trying it. Mm. But try it again.
We did have a one cider one though, didn't we?
It's got like a woody pine taste. Apple. I don't really want if I should send this to him, I don't know.
Well,
put a head on the chest. It's not bad actually. It's just the first initial taste, it's a bit.
Yeah, I mean, when I tasted there, it tastes like locust syrup or something.
The inspiration for the name of this beer was the local literary genius, the Bronte family. The connection between the Brontes and Admiral Lord Nelson is that Patrick Bronte took the name Bronte from Admiral Lord Nelson's of the Duke of Brontë. I can't really read it because it's missing overprint. The Irish name Brunty as to honour Admiral when Patrick moved to England in the 1800s. Old Bear Brewery is based in Keighley, West Riding of Yorkshire. All our ales are brewed with natural ingredients to produce a true Yorkshire flavoursome beer.
I give a pass on that one.
Now, camera says, really, contains malted wheat and barley. Pour carefully to ensure a clear glass of beer. It's very clear and it's very flat and it's very dead. This bottle conditioned beer and may contain sediment.
I think the sediment's died.
I think the sediment left the beer a long time ago because there's none in there. As you can see, a beer this strong would have sediment still floating in it and there's none there at all.
No. I think it's evaporated.
No, a lot of beers, it would stick to the rim of the thing. I don't think there's sediment at all in this beer. I think they must have forgot to put it in the bottle. It starts to get more palatable.
Do you want to put some more in?
it gets a little palatable the more you drink it, but it reminds me of Old Rat's Tail from Gwat King. That were really sour. It's like it's you in the highballs with a sharp needle. But you've got to keep trying, push it forward. If they still made this beer, I wouldn't buy it.
No.
I only bought it because I wanted to try it.
I'm disappointed with this beer because a lot of their beers
used to be
nice.
Really nice.
And
as of late.
The last couple of years when they've been bottling it, it's just not been bit.
No.
It's been dead or...
And it says it may contain sediment. It does not contain any sediment. And at 12.5%, no, you'd see it. It'd be stuck in a corner of the glass there. And there's none there, is there?
No.
At first, it's really bad, isn't it?
But yeah, you just... you get that sour taste. It's in eyeballs.
Yeah, and it does get almost drinkable. The alcohol content, you can't tell. I think it's just the sourness of it.
Mm. It just throws you off everything, you know what I mean?
I won't buy this again. But I had to buy it because I wanted to try it because there were only two last bottles available.
Mm.
Andrew's had it before and he didn't like it and we had to...
I was disappointed because it was dead. The beer would if you look, it's probably almost like a barley wine.
But I think the barley wine's a little thicker in colour. That's too clear.
Yeah, that's weird. That's weird. That's the weird thing about it. It's very clear for barley wine, and but it's got the strength and intense.
I mean, there's no lacing at all. There's no nothing. It's just. Yeah. You take care.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.